I'm a very proud doctor. I don't know how you feel wearing this white coat, but I am an extremely proud doctor. And therefore, it makes my blood boil when people say all doctors are thugs. It makes my blood absolutely boil. I came into medicine because my father was a doctor. He tried his best to make sure I didn't become a doctor. He kept saying, "You're so smart, why should you be a doctor?" And today, unfortunately, there are times when I look back at my father's memory and think, maybe there was an easier way to make a living. Because when you wake up when people turn around and say, and I've heard lots of leaders in society also say this, "Tum doctors to paise ke piche bhagte rehte ho." And I'm like, "Aur aap? Aap kiske piche bhagte hain? मैं तो उसी समाज से आया हूं जिस समाज ने आपको पैदा किया. आपकी ये उपेक्षा मुझसे क्यों है? Why do you have these expectations from me? I didn't want to be God. I don't want to be God. I don't want to be dog. I just want to be another human being. I just want you to respect me for what I do, just the way I respect you. And trust me, nothing can be more difficult than saving the life of another human being. Nothing at all. There are times when people who are in management say, today was a very bad day. My boss yelled at me. You know what's a bad day for us? Someone has died. Are you trying to tell me that I'm happy because someone has died? Even painters are extremely proud of the painting they create. And if doctors and surgeons were amongst the best that society had academically when they went into their respective fields, are you saying I'm happy that the patient died and I'm counting the notes? If that is the case, then should society be asking itself, what have we degenerated into? Because if our best cannot be trusted, then what does it say about society in general? I sometimes get really upset that airfares are going up. Does this mean I should beat up the pilot? Because unfortunately, the pilot has no role in this. And sometimes the doctor has no role in this. Costs in healthcare, even in cosmetic surgery, which is a specialty I practice, costs in healthcare in India are 1/10 that of Thailand. I'm not even talking of the US, I'm talking of Thailand. And probably with 3 times the competence and the level of English, etc., that we speak. If Indians cannot afford our services, the fault is not ours. The fault has to be someone else's. If medical seats today are more expensive than probably palatial bungalows in other countries, the fault is not ours. I didn't design the system. If there are so many other reasons why the best academically are not getting into medicine, sorry, the fault is not mine. I didn't choose the system. And so why should I bear the cudgels of something that I didn't choose? Something I didn't create, something that you didn't ask me before creating, but yet I must bear the cross for that. Why? Why? Why should I bear that? I remember 1 year ago, I was operating. On one day, we had one HIV positive patient, one hepatitis B patient, and one patient who was into full-blown AIDS. By the end of the surgeries, the entire operating room, because we were performing some very complex facial procedures, was covered in blood. We were all bathed in blood. How much can double gloves and a space suit like a thing protect you? Are you telling me I love money so much that I want to die of HIV? And if that is true, then why don't you go ahead, or whoever's not a doctor, come in and try and make sure how funny it is to make money and be woken up at 3 a.m. and go and see a patient when your child and your wife are next to you and they want you to go to sleep? Why is it that doctors in India have a 30% greater suicide rate than other communities? Why is it that doctors live approximately 9 years less, according to the Indian Medical Association data, than the average life expectancy of Indians? Why is it that Indians who had an average life expectancy of 32 years at independence today live up to 69 years, which is double and more, and yet no one seems to recognize what we are doing as a specialty or as people? Is it that we are doing bad work? Or is it that we are bad at communication? Or is it that, my dear friends, We are bad-mouthing each other so much that the patient has no ability but to agree. So the next time that you become a doctor, please think about one thing. If you will take shortcuts and if you will run down your own community, there will come a time when people will come after you. That time, don't stand up and say, no one stood for me. So it's very, very important to understand some of these issues which are happening. Stick together as a community and do amazing work